Welcome everybody to the final round. You know what this deck reminds me of? Just like a solid cube deck. It's card draw, cheap removal, you know. Doom Traveler. Not cool. Not really sure which land to lead out with. I don't think I'm going to be counterspelling anything next turn. Yeah, it's definitely a tap land, but this allows me to go like Flame Slash, Lonely Sandbar, go. All these one drops just that are so resilient to removal. I mean, it's there for a reason because of all these good efficient decks, basically. Yeah, we'll go with the Preordain, I guess. Well, that's one piece of the combo, but is that what we're looking to do right now, or do we just want, like, Seagate Oracle? I think I can just bottom both. I'd rather just draw Seagate Oracle. Quicksand. So mono white deck. I really don't want to Flame Slash that. All right, well, this doesn't feel good because we're gonna have to like discard two cards. We'll just, yeah, discard two cards here. So I think it's going to be like a Lightning Bolt and probably not land. I think it's just like if we draw more action, that's going to be fine. All right, we'll discard those two. Although, if they play a 4 toughness creature, I'm going to feel very silly. Or like a battle creature, I don't know. Is that a no, that's uncommon. I've never seen this deck before. I mean, that is a cool thing about Pauper. Sometimes you just play against like, yeah. You play against Bruise. I kind of want to just like play out these Mold Drifters. So, let's just play the sandbar and just pass, I guess. That way, like, I'm not going to have to discard either. Next turn, I can go, like, Peregrine Drake into Mold Drifter. All right. Some kind of tokens. Well, I'm going to kill the Suture Priest. Sure, my opponent could have a Raise the Alarm here, but they could have played that earlier. Alright. Time to go nuts. Or get Mana Tithe. I don't know. I'm not exactly sure. I don't even know if Mana Tithe is a common or not, but... Bam. It's a good turn. Very solid. We have so much value. Alright, Journey to Nowhere, sure. Probably on the Peregrine Drake, so I can't combo off, yeah. But, I mean, if you just look at this hand, I can just get my opponent through value. Also, we can just, obviously, find another Peregrine Drake. This deck has so much, you know, deck manipulation and card draw. So we don't care about our opponent gaining life. Just play more Mold Drifters. Can never go wrong playing more Mold Drifters. Although, actually, Seagate Oracle might have been better. If I don't draw a land here, it's going to be really awkward. God, why? I'm so bad. I am just so bad at this game. Should have just played Seagate Oracle. I got greedy. I wanted the value fish. But I'm actually giving up value by doing this, I think. So Battle Screech is in fact a common. It's okay, we got all these... Like, unless there's a way to pump all these creatures, which there very likely might be. But I feel like, you know, my opponent, this deck has a difficult time stopping the combo. Especially if I just leave up mana to counter or Ghostly Flicker. Because all we need now is an Archaeomancer. Let's play this. Suppose I'm just gonna flicker like these two. Just because we have so much mana already. Get a little extra value. Oh, I just realized that, yeah, I should probably kill the Seraph Ascendant at Soul's Attendant at some point. All right, now we can play Seagate Oracle. Now we just need the, we need the Archaeomancer. So I want to keep up, so I'm going to play that, because I want to keep up Counterspell plus Ghostly Flicker. I mean, I'm probably just Ghostly Flickering again if my opponent's just, all right, sure, you can gain life. This does make it a little more time consuming when we do get off our combo, I guess, but... Is this Triplicate Spirits? My opponent is definitely going wide, if you will. But I still don't think that's too much of an issue with the three blockers that we have and we're at 14 life. Wow, spot removal is just awful. Maybe I want to counter that one though. Or I'll counter that one. So much value. I mean, I appreciate the value. I do. Jeez. Yep. All right, let's go kill this old attendant here. All right, let's play Compulsive Research. If you find an Archaeomancer, we're good. Discard land. Discard mountain, I guess. Geez, so 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. My opponent has a lot of flyers. Maybe I just flame slash. Oh god, this feels so bad. 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Wow. So we go to 15 here. We can block 4 things. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right. I still have Counterspell up. We got to eat a lot of creatures, but I think my opponent is going to attack with everything next turn. And we're going to actually have to find the Archaeomancer. All right, we're at 5 life. 4 blockers. Target attacking creature without flying gets -1/-2 until end of turn. Okay, so how much mana do we have? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If I flicker like 2 Mold Drifters, that can find me more answers. 4, 8. Okay, so I can block 4 creatures and bolt 1 thing. So if I draw another removal spell or a creature, I'm set. If I flicker Peregrine Drake plus Mold Drifter, I could also flicker land. I could flicker my Swiftwater Cliffs to survive and kill a bunch of things, but I think I'd rather just draw cards. And if we just miss completely, then I'm sad. So yeah, we can attack, flicker both, and just hope to draw like a removal spell or a creature. Alright, so we'll do this, I guess. Okay, that's good. Life gain land would have been nice. But this does mean that we survive. That's important. We just really need to find an Archaeomancer still. And I might actually, yeah. Oh, I don't get to keep a counterspell. I think I might have tapped incorrectly, actually. Okay, well, that's a lot of removal. So let's flame slash a spirit. Feels bad, but gotta do what you gotta do. Flame slash another spirit. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we can play an island here and still have Lightning Bolt plus Counterspell. We've drawn a whole lot of cards, but this deck, my opponent's deck is very good at going wide. I don't even know if we need to use this Lightning Bolt actually. Let's see. Block, 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 block. Then my opponent will have 4 creatures left. What does Suture Priest do? Because I want to kill that, but also save Counterspell. Alright. We're at 1. Definitely countering that. Okay. So I think we're gonna cycle here instead of gaining a life. So let's tap that. Cycle. Action. Okay. Seagate Oracle. Peregrine Drake. All right, eventually we're going to find the answer. I guess it's better to like play around Journey to Nowhere. Also like when the time comes, we can just kill them, you know? All right, no attacks. What? Okay, I don't know what's happening here. I mean, I'm sure I'm gonna get blown out here somehow. Oh, like maybe like pump your whole team or something like that. All right, so then I wanna keep the Peregrine Drake alive. Sure. What is this? I do not know what this is. Am I gonna die to this? What is happening? Okay. Yes! And we got there, folks. Okay. So, just go ahead and play all of our stuff. Whoops. I even misclicked. Because I am a Munson. All right, ghostly flicker. Actually, I'm gonna play the boilerworks here. Play the ghostly flicker. This just makes it faster. Yeah. I should have probably attacked first. I'm playing this pretty loose because I'm a little bit concerned on time. Like, if they make you play it out, then it definitely takes some time. So that's why I play the boilerworks, just to make it faster. But yeah, I just want a handful of counter spells. Can I like auto yield to this? All right, gonna pause. All right, so I think I set up a relatively safe position here. I can counterspell and then I can still flicker and get counterspell again. So, yeah, this is where we're at. I guess with two Archaeomancers, I can just get back like infinite counter spells. But yeah, my opponent cannot win from this spot. It's very unlikely, at least. Oh, maybe I shouldn't have attacked with the Archaeomancer. I guess I can flicker, but I just want to make this fast because I'm low on the clock. And I have another Archaeomancer in my hand, so we can afford to play a little bit looser here. Ghostly flicker these two. Just want to flicker some stuff. This is pretty crazy. This is just pretty ridiculous. What this deck can do. two, three, four, five. Just play another one of these. Get back counterspell. I guess I could also lightning bolt my opponent out, but it feels nicer having a million counterspells in my hand. Let's firebolt this thing. Just because why not? Why not? We can do everything. We can do everything. Two life. Double counterspell. This should be the game. Not a whole lot the mono white deck can do, so. I mean, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, we have 12 power and we have 12 flyers in play. My opponent might just attack with the soldiers. No, okay. All right. So we're not gonna have as much time here for the next few games. Do not want any of these cards. Electricity seems fantastic. So definitely board those in. I like Counterspell too. Yeah. And like some of these burn spells aren't great. I don't know if I should like be boarding them out, but I feel like the best thing for us to do in this matchup is to just, combo. So I need to play fast so I can kind of get that combo going. Like I said before, spot removal just does not seem great. They don't put a ton of pressure on you. I'm just gonna cut two flame slashes for electricities because at least lightning bolt is instant speed. Like for the most part, just like almost all the spot removal is bad. Like counterspell is much better. All right, definitely keeping this. And again, we're gonna be playing some turbo magic here. Turbo. Or about as turbo as this deck can attempt to pull off, I guess. If anything, we're gonna catch up to our opponent's clock. That's the goal. That's the goal here. Secret Priest, okay. I think we can sandbag this a little bit for a little bit. Also, we have the Archaemancer to get it back, jeez. So, I mean, I'm not gonna sandbag it too much. So like, you know, if my opponent plays, actually it's probably better just to cast this. Like if my opponent plays, I don't know, Raise the Alarm or something. Or Squadron Hawk, Suture Priest, okay. Maybe a Doom Traveler. I think I'm gonna take one. Ooh, no attacks, interesting. So yeah, I'm just gonna cast this with Overload. That way I can play Compulsive Research. This card land. Don't really need cycle land here. Battle Screech. All right. I kind of want to use this as a surprise effect. So I think I just want to Seagate Oracle here, maybe. Take the Preordain because we're just looking to combo here. And I'm actually just gonna fire off a Fling Slash here. This makes it harder to flashback with the battle with the battle screech. And again, I want to wait till like turn 6 where I can go Archaeomancer into Electricery and then Overload. All right, so Triplicate Spirits, okay. And then Battle Screech. Whew, that's a lot of damage. I think we'll be okay though. We could also just draw into it. Spirit Bane. Or just try to find the combo here. I really don't want that either. Compulsive Research. Nice, see it, Oracle. No flying. Discard. Land, I guess. I'm probably going to just get rid of a bolt or something. If my opponent has a way to pump their team, we're in trouble, but don't think we could have done too much. I don't want to discard another land. I think it's probably Lightning Bolt. Also, we can attack here. Bam, get you for one. I mean, I guess if I'm gonna Electricery, I should just do it main phase. Do they have like a Borrowed Grace or something? Fortify? Yeah. Yeah, I really just want to combo off here if I can. My opponent's doing the math. If they have two pump effect, two plus O your team effects, then we're dead. All right. Just gonna attack, I guess. Oh, you know what? No, no attack. My opponent could just like raise the alarm or something. So the reason why I'm casting it this turn is if my opponent has like a pump effect, like Borrowed Grace or something, I want to be able to make it so I just don't die. All right, so my opponent did have a raise the alarm. Okay, this is good. Give me some Peregrine Drake. All the card draw in the planet. Squadron Hawks for days. It's okay, we got all these Mole Drifters though. All right, so they're just gonna get three more Squadron Hawks. Wait, just one? What? What's going on here? Is their hand just all Squadron Hawks? Chose not, so the, our opponent's hand is two Squadron Hawks? No. All right, and there we go. Peregrine Drake. If my opponent lets this resolve, we're in super good shape. Yep. All right, time to pause it again, folks. Time to pause it again. I'll be right back. Hey, you know what? This is the last match. I'll let you guys see the beauty. But basically, the idea is we're just going to play a bunch of, we're just generating a ton of mana here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Get this back. Just do this enough time so I can just play everything without having to worry. We have plenty of time here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ghostly Flicker. Bam, bam. So like every time I flicker, it's like a new object, I guess. So I can't like auto yield. Does F7 just put everything on the stack by itself? No, all right, whatever. Okay, this should be good enough. All right, now I'm just gonna start playing things. Okay. So yeah, let's just start casting Mole Drifters. Let's play this for value. I guess we can play this and generate even more mana. Yeah, but yeah, once this deck goes off, it's kind of silly. And just looking for things to do with my mana. All right, counterspell's good. Discard land. I think that's good enough. I guess I should have cast the burn spell. Eh, who needs land anyways here? Yeah, Electricry, far better in this matchup than in the Delver matchup. I'll say that much. All right, and we got there. Whew. That was fun. That was fun. I know it takes a little bit of time to set up, but yeah, I mean, one of the big reasons why I think this deck is so successful, I mean, obviously the combo is powerful, but this deck just has access to, you know, just all the great cheap spells in the format, like Flame Slash, Lightning Bolt. It just gives you so much time to get to the late game. You know, you have a ton of card draw, but when you have access to a bunch of cheap removal, I mean, it's very synergistic, you know, being able to go like Lightning Bolt, Compulsive Research, or on turn 4 even, you know, Evoke Mole Drifter or Compulsive Research and cast removal spell is huge. It allows you to come back when you're behind because you have all this cheap removal, and then of course you have the combo. And the thing is with this deck, you don't even need the combo sometimes to win the game. If you just draw a bunch of Mole Drifters and Drakes, a lot of times that'll be enough because you have all this, you have the removal and you have ways to recur it. So that was Blue-Red Izzet Drake, widely considered to be the best deck in Pauper, and a lot of people are trying to beat it but having difficulty doing so. The mono blue deck actually seems like it has a reasonable game against the deck, or I'm just playing it horribly. And again, I am very curious to see what your sideboard plans are for that matchup, because I clearly didn't get it 100%, and I would be interested to know what to do for that matchup. But thank you for watching 3-2. This was Blue Red Izzet Drake for Pauper. See you all next week.